Hey, what up? It's Will Maker. Today I'm going to go over group send and return tracks in FL Studio. If you need help setting this up in Ableton, I have a separate video for that. So groups and buses can help organize a session. They can also help glue things together, and they can just help you work more efficiently. So with that, let's go ahead and dive in. Groups are any number of faders or channels that are linked and controlled by a single fader or a bus in this case. A few things that are great to group together are drums and background vocals. You can put your drums in a group and help glue them together by adding some compression. So say for instance you have a huge session and you got four background vocals and you got six plugins on each of those background vocals. So you have 24 plugins now on four background vocals. Depending on how powerful your computer is, it can definitely slow it down. So what you can do instead is you can take the four background vocals and you can put those into a group. And now you can just process just the bus. And now you're just using six plugins versus using the 24 on each of the individual tracks. This is how you group in FL. First, make sure that all the tracks in your group are assigned to a mixer track right here. Now take any open track. I'll take insert 5 since there's nothing routed to this track in the channel rack. I also recommend naming your bus and tracks. I'll name this drum bus. I also like to dock my bus to the right. So when you hear the term drum bus, this is what it's referring to. Now highlight the tracks you want to group. On a Mac, you can hold Shift and Command and then click. Now once they're highlighted, come over to our bus fader and you're going to right click right down here. And you're going to route to this track only. If you don't choose this, your bus will be routing to the bus and the master fader, which is what you don't want. Now, if I unclick, I still have individual control of the faders as well. But now I can control my drums just from this one fader. Finally, we have send and return tracks. A lot of times, first-time engineers and producers will ask, what are these used for? Send tracks can help give you a cohesive sound using one or two of the same reverbs. They can also help save CPU power so you don't have to add 12 separate reverbs for each track. Now you can just add one or two per session or to taste. To set this up, you'll just need to go to an open insert. I'll use this one right here. I'm going to go ahead and name the reverb. I'll go ahead and I'll dock this to the right again. You can also color this. Now you can add your effect on here. This is considered the return track. On the return track, you can also add any plugin of your choice. So you can add delays, distortion, feel free to experiment. So just remember, the track that your effect is on, that's your return track. Now we're going to highlight the track that we want our effect on. And now we're going to route it to our reverb. So you just come down here and you're just going to click. Now you have individual control with this. So if we listen. At any time that you want to disconnect this, just go ahead and highlight the track that you want to disconnect, and then you come over here and you just unclick it. So this is going to be your send. So once again, feel free to experiment. You can add delays, you can add saturation. You can do this all on your return track. So that's a quick summary of what groups and buses are and send and returns are. So if you like content like this, please feel free to like and subscribe. Other than that, peace out.